Any identification on the victim?
Puzzle piece.
But Jigsaw has been dead for 10 years.
It's not him. Can't be.
This was on the body.
The truth will set you free.
The reason I think Jigsaw's an icon is because he's not a slasher. He doesn't kill. He doesn't run around through forest. He's not getting a girl in the shower. He's not doing where everyone's screaming at the theater. He's behind, and he's actually a real thinker. He's an engineer. When you're talking about Jigsaw and you're talking about John Kramer, is he the protagonist? Is he the antagonist? When you're talking about in real film structure, is he the hero or is he the villain? One of the things we really tried to do in this one is get back to Saw 1, which what was some of our favorites. A lot of ours are favorite one, and not because it's the first one. And I think in Saw 1, there was a lot more thinking and a lot more jumps rather than blood and gore. And so we really tried to get back to Saw 1 in jumps and scares and a lot more logic.
It was a game.
One of the things we do with the Saw movies, we always like to have fun and give little winks and nods and little tiny pieces that real fans of the movies will be like, wait, that's from that, or that's for that. That's Saw 3. That's the guy from Saw 3 walking in the background, or that. And we've really always tried to do that. So we won't disappoint our fans in this one.
I'm chasing a dead man.
Just running scared.
After seeing Daybreakers and Predestination, they're absolutely perfect. They'd worked with Lionsgate before. They also brought their DP, Ben Knott, who's incredible. And what they bring and what the Spirit Brothers bring to this is they want their own take. They don't want to make Saw 8. They don't want to make a Saw movie. We've changed color. We've changed sound. We've changed characters. We've changed the whole palette of a Saw movie and still kept it as a Saw movie.
No, it's not creepy at all.